Yo, welcome to Haíɫzaqv territory. This is the central coast of British Columbia, where Canada meets the Pacific Ocean. There's lots to explore along these shores. We're here to see how it's all related. So let's connect the dots and draw a picture of this place, where land meets sea. If you look to the east, you'll see the peaks of the Kitimat Range, part of the Coast Mountains. 150 million years ago, much of this was underwater. But over time, tectonic plates collided and volcanoes erupted, pushing up the earth and forming these tall mountains. If you look closely, you might even see a bit of white at the top. That's ice and snow. And when it melts, it turns into streams that turn into rivers that eventually run down through these thick, vast forests, carrying thousands of migrating salmon on their way to and from the sea. That's right, salmon might not ski, but they do depend on snow-covered mountains to survive. It's a long journey up and down the slopes. We are, after all, in the largest temperate rainforest in the world. It's roughly the same size as Ireland. What does temperate mean? Well, it just means that the climate here is not too hot, not too cold, it's just right. Perfect for these tall moss-covered trees. Some of these are 1,000 years old and can grow 10 times taller than a telephone pole. Their massive roots help hold the riverbanks in place. And they create a canopy that covers almost the entire ground, which means shade for the rivers, which in turn helps keep that water nice and cool. And that's just how the salmon like it. Eventually, those cool rivers reach the coast. Look around. You're now in an estuary. A lively meeting place where nutrients from the forest mix with those from the ocean. Each estuary, like each river, is unique. But they all share one common connection. This is where freshwater meets saltwater, which means migrating salmon must change their bodies to meet the demands of the journey to and from the ocean. Further out, the land begins to break up, forming countless inlets and coves, and tens of thousands of islands. In and around these islands is another forest, a forest beneath the surface. And out here, kelp can grow up to 2 feet per day. And this rich habitat supports all kinds of life. And that includes humans. Humans have occupied this region for tens of thousands of years. And like for so many people around the world, we live on the land, but depend on the sea. We gather herring eggs, we fish salmon, we harvest seaweed, and so much more. And we are always mindful of our place, mindful that we are interconnected, that we are a part of it all, above, below, and along this great meeting place of land and sea.